Dell here from Hubbard's Ladies Anglers and a proud Hubbard supporter. I am going to do a short video today on what to bring for women to pack on the 39-hour trip, and maybe some men would be interested in knowing what to bring also. So, first thing, what not to bring: cell phone, purse. Really don't need this stuff. It'll go back in my car. Okay, I highly recommend boots. Flip-flops can be dangerous on a boat. You can get a hook on your foot. I almost got severely damaged on that way. Boots, it's a very least close coat too. Rain gear. It's very important. It might not rain. You might say that the weather forecast is perfect. However, sometimes if you're in rough water, the water will splash because you are in the where it is. You might say it's summer, you don't need a jacket, but it does get cool in the water at night. This is a new gadget that I'm going to try that I discovered on my last 39-hour trip, where you put this by your fishing spot, tie it on with zip ties, and you have a nice place to keep your pliers, your hook release, anything that towels, anything that you would need. You don't need this, but sometimes it comes in handy. Sometimes when you're catching a lot of fish, it's good to know the size so you can vent them and get them back in the water real quick, along with your other tech. The seats are hard. This is a cushion. It will blow off, so make sure that when you have it on the boat, you're either sitting on it or you have your tackle box on it so it doesn't blow away. This is a sleeping bag. The bunks are very comfortable. However, they are just vinyl bunks. So even if it's in the summer, bring a sleeping bag because you can sleep on top of it and it gives you some cushion. Pillow. Garbage bags come in handy as well for dirty fish clothes at the end of the trip. If you have a special pillow, you can bring it. I bring a knee pillow. And I bring a blanket. Like I said, it's on the water at night and it does get chilly. Okay, this is not a necessity, but the floors on the boat are made of aluminum or steel or some metal, but they're very hard. So this is a cushion pad, and it really helps with leg cramps and keeping your feet from getting sore on the boat. I strongly recommend a wet bag or dry bag, whichever way you see it. I pack them differently than I do my backpack. This, I always keep sanitizing wipes because you will want to wipe down your bun or clean your hands from fish when you're eating snacks. You need, again, waterproof shirt, sunglasses, more sunglasses in case the other pair fall in the water. Sunscreen is very important. Waterproof pants. Love, more than one pair, because typically they get wet and stinky, so if you want to change them, but they're not a necessity, you can use one on one hand and one on the other. Gaiters, not only are these good for the sun reflecting on your face from the water, but when you're trying to sleep at like 6 o'clock at night and it's not dark until like 10, these go very well on your eyes. I also bring extra because sometimes people forget them and I share. I always have a poncho, even though I have waterproof clothes, so that in case somebody forgot when I can find it. A towel, sleeping towels. I also keep an abundance of those. Someone just bought me this and gave it to me as a gift. It's a chilled out cooling towel. I will try this and see if I like it, but it's going to be hot out there, so I'm thinking it will be good. Dramamine. Please take Dramamine the night before, the morning of, and then every 12 hours. You might have never been seasick. I have never been seasick, but I do not want to have a trip ruined by not taking Dramamine. More sunscreen, tissues, Tic Tac. Okay. And I also have glasses wipes. The saltwater hits your glasses and you will not be able to see by the end of the trip. Okay. Now I'm going to throw all these back in. And then this is what I pack to go up on my bunk. The wet bag, the dry bag, whatever. You need that because you will get wet on the boat. Everything gets wet on the boat. That keeps your things dry and comfortable. This will stay up on your bunk. Now, the things that you have, again, sanitizing wipes so that you can wipe down your bunk. Tissues, Band-Aids, cloth, just little things that you might need. And if you're Sean Porchy, he brings his own paper towels and sanitizing equipment, so it's no joke. I have a little baggie with deodorant, toothpaste, and a toothbrush. If you've ever been in the bathroom of the boat, either one, you will know that the sink is push, push, push. Very hard to wash your face. These are Neutrogena face wipes. I suggest bringing those so you don't have to pump and try to wash your face that way. Again, another poncho. I do not take showers on the boat. Some people might tell you that it's the rite of passage that you must take a shower on a 39-hour trip. I did once, and I am telling you, that was a full-face lie from Satan. You do not have to take a shower on the boat. So, there are these adult washcloths that you can use, and you can wait for another day to take a shower and wash your hair, because just bring dry shampoo if you have to, but your hair will not be dry. I also highly recommend earplugs. Many people on the boat snore, and not only that, but people talk throughout the night, and this will help you sleep. Okay, then this is very important. Medicine. You need to bring your medicine, and it's very important that you let the crew know if you have any health concerns. I have been on the boat before where we were with the Coast Guard all night conversing on whether or not we had to have someone evacuated. No one knew. We need to know and bring your meds. Bring a couple days worth simply because you know what happened on the SS Minnow. Also, just joking about that, but the boat is rocky, and if you lose your pill, you probably won't find it, so bring an extra. Sunscreen for your lips, because not only are you getting the sun from above, you're getting it reflected on the water. I have gotten sun poisoning before because of it. And again, in this bag, I also keep Dramamine. I cannot stress this enough. You must take Dramamine if you don't want your trip to be ruined. This is the all day, less drowsy. I take one at night before I go on a trip. I took one this morning. I'll take one at about 3 o'clock when I get on the boat, and I'll take one when we start fishing at midnight. Also, these are all good tips for even a 10-hour. I've seen even 10-hour trips get ruined with seasickness, and you do not want to do that. If you do, this is not the love boat, so you do not have to bring a lot of makeup. There is no mirror in the boat. I bring a little mirror just because if there's fish scales all over my face, guys aren't going to tell you. Believe me, they're concentrating on the fish. And let's see, Q-tip, nail clippers, which can also be used as fishing tackle because they can cut the fishing line. Just bring a little bag like that. In here, I have a change of clothes, a pillowcase, my lucky fishing shirt, a clean fishing shirt to change into after I get all bloody because of all the fish I catch, and another one just for good measure. Also, socks. If you're wearing boots or shoes, they're going to get wet. You do not want your feet to be in wet socks for 39 hours. And let's see, what else do I have in here? Waterproof pants and undies, but I'm not gonna shave this. But anyway, also, I did bring this. Sometimes the crews, once you get to know them, they like certain things. So I know that some of them like licorice, so I bought licorice. It doesn't hurt, and they usually let me have some too. So again, pack light, but pack so that you have everything you need. And if I'm on the same boat, you know that I have extras, so don't forget to see me. And guys can use this information too. And there is a website, Hubbard's Marine website, that has video links for all of these things. And you can find a lot of information on those too, and I encourage you to go there. And join the Hubbard supporters page, and also the Ladies Anglers page. Just ask and we will accept you. Okay? Estelle, signing off. Hey there, I forgot something. On a 39-hour fishing trip, you typically have to sleep a little bit on the way out in order to be awake for the 20 straight hours of fishing. So